various interviews that you would never go into the studio without doing pre-production with a band. Why do you think pre-production to make an album is so important?
Look, there's a time when I think people were able to make really good music. Just sort of sitting down with the guitar and knocking a couple of chords out, working out a melody, some lyrics, you know, but there ain't no more Muddy Waters or anyone like that. And people can't make records like that anymore. You know, I think the ability to do that is just gone. And more people are relying on being able to multi-track instruments and having a lot of other ideas that augment, instruments that augment their musical ideas. And people simply don't write songs that have that kind of emotional power when you hear them. It takes a lot of time to flesh a piece of music out. Obviously some of these songs are exceptional in that sense, but it took a long time to actually get some of them to be written. So without that process, again, we wouldn't have had the kind of records that we have. And that's been the case on every record that I've ever worked on. It's imperative to have preparation.
Yeah, but now that you mention it, like, of course, making a good song takes time and effort, but in today's music with modern technology, everything is done much faster, squared. Everything seems to be like in its place, but it's just based on a formula, soulless in many ways, no? How do we create good, memorable songs?
This is the direction that the music business has been going in for decades. You know, I mean, the end result of this particular cycle, I think, is that people who manufacture music want to be in complete control of it. So I think the direction is to create music by AI, which if you've heard the results of that, I'm sure you know that they're probably a long way off from being able to do anything that you'd ever want to listen to. But the thing is that for a long time now, people haven't been making records where you have that same kind of urgency and that kind of emotional investment. You know, I mean, we're living Super Unknown right now, obviously. It's a record that was made in 1993. It's almost 30 years old. You know, I mean, it's getting close. It's almost 30 years old. Jesus. But people still listen to this record. People still love this record. That's insane. I mean, I have no problem with it. It makes me very happy because people tell me all the time, oh, it's such a good record. And it is a good record. I know this. But the thing is that by all rights, people shouldn't be listening to this record anymore. You know, I remember when I was growing up in the 1970s and, you know, doo-wop music, which is music that was like 15, 16 years old, that was still getting played at radio, but we would laugh at it because it was preposterous. It sounded so old-fashioned and quaint, and it had no relationship to how we felt as kids. You know, I mean, I love doo-wop music now, but that's beside the point. You know, the main point is that music has always developed. It's always evolved naturally. And we've hit a point right now where it's not evolving at all. We're just kind of in this stasis right now. It's kind of on, the brakes have been hit for a while. And the main reason for that, people aren't willing to emotionally invest themselves in the music that they do. Yeah, I mean, rushing plays a great big part in making people's music now because we simply don't have the resources to work. But if you try and allocate your resources and consider, okay, I don't have enough money to do X, Y, and Z, I have to figure out a different way to do this so you can feel the commitment at the back end. I mean, people technically talk about ergonomics and the ease of making a record. I can assure you that no one who listens to a record gives a very shit about your ergonomics or how easy it was for you to make a record or what kind of plugins you use. They just want to hear good music. And if they don't hear anything that inspires them, it's going to be boring to them. You know, pop music has got like a certain sticky quality to it, but it lasts for a very short time. It's got like maybe per song, maybe 2 to 6 months lifespan. And then you don't hear it anymore. And that's because the pop music that people make, once again, like no one's invested in it. There's no emotional investment. So you got to get that ingredient back in. You have to get the urgency back in where people really feel like, they want to be there, but they've got something they have to get out of there. So my answer to that question.
Estás escuchando LP Podcast.